That's what I call an ovation. You see, I didn't know what to expect, but I could tell you people really do appreciate the man who finally shut The Rock's mouth.
Huh? I don't think so. Well, they did. I think that ovation just changed.
Now, you see, that's more of the backwoods, unappreciative, disrespectful.
Uh-oh. Easy, this is Arkansas.
Response that I would get from a bunch of hillbillies like you.
It's a little dirty right now.
You see, I didn't expect much from you because I learned a long time ago, don't look for much from people who have no reason to respect themselves. Now last Thursday on SmackDown, don't make me come out there.
See? He needs to come.
Thursday on SmackDown, a man showed me no respect who has nothing but respect for himself. That's right, The Rock. You know what? I'm not gonna waste any more of my time with you podunks.
This is what happened last Thursday. The Rock.
Because quite frankly, the smell is starting to get to me. Look. You see that? The Rock.
The Rock cost The Undertaker the match with Maven.
The hardcore time?
You know he did, JR.
That was a shot of an unwarranted, unprovoked attack perpetrated on The Undertaker by The Rock.
Unwarranted, that's right. Unprovoked even.
Now I tell you what. It's one thing not showing me my proper respect, but nobody, and I mean nobody, disrespects me like that. Because if you do disrespect me, if I can bring it up one more time, I will show you what will happen.
We ain't even next week, and at No Way Out, we damn sure ain't gonna be even.
And The Rock was being interviewed, as you saw the assault from behind, we should add, by The Undertaker. And man, this, it was bad enough with those big suit bones. The choke slam with a hook in them up. But The Undertaker walks it through, King.
You got that right. Watch this. And listen. Listen to The Rock's hit. Being tombstone. Listen.
Oh, The Rock's skull on the top of that limo.
Oh, my. We ain't even.
Oh, sure as hell aren't even.
I'm proud of that.
Now that is what I call an ass kicking. But see, it doesn't end right there. No. We're just now getting started.
Uh-oh. Is it gonna get worse?
The beatings will continue until I teach Rock the word respect. And believe me, I am no Aretha Franklin, and I won't be singing it. I will continue to beat the word respect into The Rock's head until he sings R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Taker, that's what you mean to me.
Well, speaking of respect,
what are you talking about? The co-owner of the Keep your words soft and sweet. You might have to eat them.
This is a very volatile situation.
Yeah.
Excuse me. But I want to follow through on what you're talking about. Because in my estimation, you may clearly be the most respected wrestler of all time.
Oh, smart. Kiss up.
Not only in the ring, but in the dressing room. I'm saying that, and if I say it, it stands for everybody else. And clearly these fans, over the years, whether they've liked you or not liked you, have respected you for being the Undertaker, the dead man.
Where's he going with this?
But last Thursday night, to continue, you lost all our respect. You caused The Rock to have a grade one concussion, a serious neck injury. Hell, you could have ended his career.
Who are you to tell me that you don't respect me?
Uh-oh.
Who in the hell are you?
I knew this was gonna happen.
Blow up right here.
I'm Ric Flair, 50% owner of this company, and I'm telling you that.
I think the Undertaker cares about that.
Well, let me tell you something, Mr. 50%. When the real owner, he gives me the word, I'm gonna bust your ass.
Well, until that happens, I got some bad news for you.
What's he talking about?
First part being that this Sunday at No Way Out, The Rock will be there live and in person. And he told me he's gonna bring everything he has for the dead man.
He's gonna need it.
Yeah. I got some more bad news for you. Tonight, one-on-one,
he's getting ready to run.
The dead man, the phenom, the Undertaker, the American badass is gonna wrestle here tonight.